Is the cat alive? Is it dead? I bet you know what we're talking about. It's probably one of the most famous cats in the world. Indeed, we're talking about Schrödinger's cat. This is a famous paradox that tries to illustrate how weird the microscopic world is by applying concepts of quantum mechanics to everyday life. And the consequences are very bizarre. Do you want to know more about this? Watch this video and I'll tell you. Before talking about Schrödinger's cat, let's introduce briefly its owner first. Erwin Schrödinger was an Austrian physicist born in 1887. He provided several important contributions in many fields of physics, such as statistical mechanics, cosmology, and thermodynamics. However, his most notable results were probably those related to quantum mechanics. Quantum mechanics is a branch of physics that tries to explain this behavior of particles at a microscopic level. We may think that atoms and elementary particles act by following laws similar to those that we observe in the macroscopic world. Well, let me tell you, not even close. In fact, the microscopic world is quite bizarre. Atoms and particles do not behave as we would expect. There are indeed several weird phenomenons that characterize the quantum world. To show how strange these phenomena can be, Schrödinger ideated his famous paradox of the cat. Let's see what this is about. So here's the paradox. Let's imagine to have a cat and to put it inside a steel chamber. In the same chamber, there is also a tiny amount of radioactive substance. In a radioactive substance, each atom has a certain probability of decaying. This means a certain atom may decay, but also may not. The amount of substance in the chamber is tuned such that there's 50% probability that one atom will decay over a time interval of 1 hour, and a 50% probability that no atom will decay. Furthermore, there is also a Geiger-Müller counter inside the chamber. A Geiger-Müller counter, also known as a GM tube, is an instrument used to detect particles emitted by a radioactive decay. In this case, if the atom in the substance decays, a particle will be detected by this Geiger-Müller counter. But it's not over there. This detector is also connected to a small hammer, so if the Geiger-Müller counter detects a particle emitted as a result of radioactive decay, the hammer will be released and will shatter a flask containing hydrocyanic acid, a deadly poison that eventually will kill the cat. To summarize, if an atom in the radioactive substance decays, the acid in the flask will be released and the poor cat will die. If no atom in the radioactive substance decays, the acid will remain inside the flask and the cat will survive. So far, nothing too strange. However, a weird situation occurs if we try to apply the laws of quantum mechanics to this situation. In fact, according to quantum mechanics, the atom in the radioactive substance is at the same time in two different states, decayed and non-decayed. We will see this in more detail later. What are the implications of this fact? It may sound totally nonsense, but this means that the cat is also in two different states, dead and alive, both at the same time. And what is even more weird is this is true only until the chamber is sealed and nobody is observing the cat. The moment somebody opens the chamber and looks inside, the cat will either instantly be dead or alive. Okay, all of this probably sounds nonsense, I agree. But in order to understand this paradox and why it leads to these weird conclusions, we need to explain a bit more how the quantum world works. So let's take a step back. The first thing we need to understand is the concept of wave function. In the macroscopic world, any physical quantity of a certain object is well defined. For example, if I throw a ball to you, we can use kinematic equations to describe exactly the position of the ball at any instant of time. And we can also use equations to calculate the velocity of the ball. Thus, in the macroscopic world, physical quantities of a certain object are perfectly definable and can be calculated, provided that we know the initial conditions. In the quantum world, things are a little bit different. The reason for this is that a particle has dual behavior in the microscopic world. It behaves both as a particle and as a wave. Let's take, for instance, an electron moving inside a box. In classical physics, the electron would have a well-defined trajectory inside the box, but this picture does not represent reality. In reality, the electron behaves as a wave, so it doesn't have a well-defined position. On the contrary, it is spread over a certain portion of space. We can imagine somehow that the electron is simultaneously present in all positions inside that region. This may sound quite disturbing, but it's something real in the quantum world. Mathematically, the position of the electron, or any particle, is described by the so-called wave function. The form of this function can be quite complicated. However, what we actually care about here is its meaning. The wave function allows us to calculate the probability of finding the electron at a certain point in space. This probability is any number between 0 and 1, so there will be regions inside the box where this number is, for instance, 0.5, which means 50% probability of finding the electron here, or other regions where it's 0.1, which means 10% of chances to find the electron there, and so on and so on. Another concept we have to understand is the following. Before any interaction with the surroundings occurs, the electron has no clear position, because all positions where the wave function has a probability greater than zero are possible. The particle doesn't have a definite position yet. It's like it exists simultaneously in every point of the allowed region of space. However, the moment we observe it, we force the system, in this case the electron in the box, to interact with the surroundings. As a result, the electron will instantly assume a well-defined position within the region of possibility, according to the probability described by the wave function, of course. This phenomenon is known as a wave function collapse. At the moment of the observation, the wave function instantly takes value of 1, which means 100% probability at a certain location, and a value of 0 everywhere else. It's like the electron instantly appears at a well-defined location. But how is all this connected to Schrodinger's cat? So, we've seen how particles behave in the microscopic world. They behave like a wave, and therefore they don't have a clear position in space until they are interacted with on the external world, for example, when we observe them. At that moment, their wave function collapses, and they take a well-definite position. This behavior is valid not only for the position of the particle, but for other physical quantities as well. Another example is the spin of an electron. It's not easy to explain what is the spin of a particle according to quantum mechanics, but we can think of it as a quantity describing the direction of its rotation. Imagine every particle is rotating around its axis. In the simplified model, the spin of an electron can only have two possible values, clockwise and anti-clockwise. When the electron is free and is not interacting with the external world, its spin, in reality, is a superposition of these two different states, clockwise and anticlockwise, existing simultaneously, both with 50% probability. But the moment we observe the electron, we make it interacting with the external world, and so its wave function collapses into one of the two possible states. As a result, its spin will now be either clockwise or anticlockwise, but not both of them. Something similar occurs with Schrodinger's cat. If we use this interpretation, in fact, the wave function of the atom in the radioactive substance has two possible states, one state in which the atom has decayed, and one state in which it has not. These states are equally likely, so when the box is closed, it's like the atom is simultaneously decayed, with 50% probability, but also not decayed, with 50% probability as well. As a result, the cat can also be described as a superposition of these two different states, equally likely a cat is alive and a cat is dead state. It sounds very bizarre, I know, but this is what we get when we try to apply the principles of the quantum world to macroscopic objects like the cat. However, when we open the box, we'll actually observe the cat, so we can cause an interaction between the system and the external world. As a result, its wave function will collapse into one of the two possible states. The cat will become either alive or dead, but not both. Of course, this explanation sounds totally ridiculous to our minds. We know that the cat must already be alive or already dead well before we open the box. It can't be dead and alive at the same time. So where's the catch? The issue is, the rules of the quantum world cannot be applied to macroscopic objects. This is because macroscopic objects contain billions of atoms. Each of them, if taken individually, behaved as we described before, it has a wave function that describes all the possible states of the atom, and when the atom interacts with the surroundings, its state collapses instantaneously into one of the several possible states. However, When we consider billions of atoms together, this effect is mediated and we are no longer able to observe this effect. But why is that? The reason is, particles in the quantum world behave as waves. When two or more waves interact with each other, a phenomenon known as interference occurs. When the waves are in phase, they'll add up, and we observe a wave with larger intensity. But when the waves are not in phase, they disrupt each other, and we no longer see them. This is exactly what happens, for instance, if you throw two small stones into a pond. A circular wave is originated from each of the points where the stone entered the water. These two waves expand and reach each other, then they will interfere. You will see the regions of water where the two waves add and produce a larger wave, and regions of where the two waves cancel each other, producing no wave at all. So in order to observe the quantum effects in the macroscopic world, the wave functions of all atoms in the objects must be aligned correctly in order to interfere in the right way. However, this is impossible given the fact that there are billions of atoms, so it's like the wave functions of the atoms interfere with each other in a destructive way, making it impossible for us to see macroscopic objects behaving as a wave. And for this reason, the cat in the box cannot be both alive and both dead at the same time, because the rules of the quantum world cannot be applied to it. We know that even if we don't open the chamber and we observe the cat, it will for sure either be alive or dead, but never both. Of course, Schrödinger didn't believe that the cat in the box was alive and dead at the same time. His only purpose was to show the general public how weird the laws of quantum mechanics are. By ideating this hypothetical system in which quantum properties are transferred from a microscopic object, the atom and the radioactive substance, to a macroscopic one, the cat. Indeed, Schrödinger himself started his original article about this paradox by writing, "One can set up a ridiculous experiment." Nonetheless, this interesting argument started a debate between scientists about questions such as, when does a quantum system stop existing as a superposition of its states? Or, how small should a system be in order to observe these quantum weird effects? These questions are very interesting and not very easy to address given the bizarre nature of the quantum world. Even Albert Einstein participated in this debate, formulating a modified version of the paradox in which he replaced the poison in the chamber with explosive gunpowder. In any case, we are quite sure there's somebody that doesn't like this debate to continue that long. The poor cat still in the chamber. This video ends here. Thanks for watching, everyone. Did you find the paradox of Schrödinger's cat interesting? Do you find the quantum universe bizarre? Are you curious to know more about it? Let me know in the comments below, be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next time on the channel.